Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. I had a suggestion a long time ago from Kevin, who's one of our regular subscribers. He actually said, hey, I'd like to see you answer some of the, you know, the questions that you get from your subscribers or comments on your channel. Go ahead, answer them. And you know what, lately, I can see a lot of people getting ready for the holidays. They want a lot of their smart home equipment working. So it's time to start that series. I have a couple of questions, obviously, about smart home bulbs and kind of getting those set up for the holidays and also just in general in your home. So let's get started with answering your smart home questions, volume one. All right, now the first question, and I'm going to answer two questions from this individual. They're complex questions, but I'm going to take the best shot I can at them. Maxim Maximov, that's his name. He joined our channel a little while ago here, and he's been asking questions about the different bulbs, the different, you know, systems and what I would choose. So let me read his question directly here. So his first question was, should I buy a Philips Hue Hub or a Philips Bridge Hub? Is it better in 2018 without it, or do I still need the Hue Hub? Now, there's a tricky piece to Philips Hue, and this is the Philips Hue box right here. This is just an A19 bulb. There's a little tricky piece to Philips, what they did with the ZigBee technology. Now, if you don't know what ZigBee is, it's a protocol for smart home or the Internet of Things, whatever you want to call it today. The smart home devices, sensors, things like that. And it's a protocol that anyone can go and use. And the other piece to that is anyone can go and modify it. So the difference, or one of the differences between Z-Wave and ZigBee, is the fact that ZigBee is an open protocol that can be modified. So what Philips Hue did, or what Philips did rather, is they went out and they modified the ZigBee protocol. They still use it relatively in its entirety, but what they've done is they've created a bit of a proprietary protocol here within ZigBee, or in part and parcel with the ZigBee protocol. So what it means to you ultimately is you will require the hub no matter what you do if you want to use Philips Hue and their set of bulbs. So for 2018, 2019, 2020, I think in general, you're going to need that hub from Philips. You're not really going to be able to find a way around it, at least as long as they want that to be the case for you in your smart home. The second part to his question is much more complex. It's basically, which one of these systems would you use? So, you know, coming kind of right to left here, or for you, left to right, this is IKEA trad-free or trade-free or whatever we want to say. It's some Swedish strange name. Philips Hue. The LifeX bulbs, or set of bulbs, this is singled element. They have a number of series as well. This is TP-Link, and this is, you know, I got sent this by a company here, and it's called LoHAS, or LoHAS LED, and it's just a standard Wi-Fi bulb, and I think we're seeing a lot of those makers come out, and they're having integration capability with a lot of systems. So I wanted to actually bring that out and talk a little bit about it and why I would purchase the different items here on this table. Okay, so to tackle this question, I've kind of split out the table here. So over here, and I just don't have a Yee light bulb with me, but the Yee light bulbs would sit here as well. This side of the table is a Wi-Fi LED smart bulb. Over here, what we have are ZigBee protocol LED bulbs. Now, the reason I've kind of split those out is because I want to talk to you about this first and foremost. What does Wi-Fi do to you as a consumer over time? Now, number one, obviously you got more network traffic. As you add more and more of these, your network traffic increases in terms of the communication going on just on between your router or a wireless access point, or, you know, if you have extenders, it doesn't matter. These are going to increase traffic on that network. And over time, as you build up that traffic on the network, just the basics of networking say you don't want to do that. It's kind of a runaway curve in terms of broken packets or broken signals or broken communication. Once it gets to a certain point of busyness, everything starts breaking and nothing will work. So in general, what I'm going to tell you is Wi-Fi is not something you want to build your smart home on. If you're only ever going to have 5 to 10 devices, go for it. These are perfect. That's great. But for me, and the question Maxim was asking, what would I be using going forward? So let's move over to this side of the table. So over on this side of the table, we have 3 different ZigBee protocol hubs, as I said, Sangled Element, the Philips Hue, and the IKEA bulbs here. And I'm gonna stop trying to say that name because it's just not working for me. Now, I'll tell you, each one kind of has their own little nuance here that you may love, you may not love. So let me just go with those really quickly. Sangled Element, standard ZigBee protocol, can connect with other ZigBee hubs like a Samsung SmartThings hub. So, you know, to me, this is the easiest to interface with other ZigBee hubs, including an Amazon Echo Plus, which has a ZigBee hub on board. So that's really nice. This is a direct interface instantaneously. The Philips Hue, the quirk there I kind of told you about earlier, it's a proprietary form of ZigBee. It's been modified and Philips wants to keep you within their system, so you will need their hub. Now, their hub and their capabilities on the flip side are really high, and I think all of their products are very high quality. I have yet to find a bulb I don't love from Philips. And, you know, so their quirk is really just that hub and the requirement to have that hub in your home per 50 bulbs. And that's a little piece of ZigBee to understand. It's kind of 50 unit or bulb limit or device limit there. So Philips has that same 50 bulb limit. That would be the same here. Now, the IKEA, I'll show you what that limitation is. Here it is right there. So you need this little controlling device. If you don't buy that, you can't get these working. There's all kinds of, you know, hack videos that they'll show you where you can try and power reset the hub and power reset the bulb and what have you. But honestly, it doesn't work very well. It's spotty at best. And even when you do it, you still end up having to connect it to a ZigBee hub. So what are you doing? So, you know, you can clearly see that I'm preferring in my home because these give me the opportunity to have 50 devices connected on their hub, on their system. All right, so let's go through just the last kind of touch pieces here between these 3 bulbs. If you're building a smart home, you know, what are the real benefits? Again, these have proprietary hubs, you're stuck within them. The Sangled Element can go out to Samsung SmartThings, can go to my Echo Plus. They don't have to use their own hub or their own application to manage them. I like that about them. The thing that's maybe a little bit better, you know, for a product like Philips Hue here is HomeKit integration, Google Home integration, Amazon Echo integration, or their voice assistant as well. So there's really no platform that you can't use Philips on. They can connect to Samsung SmartThings as well. So you still will need the hub. Don't get me wrong there, but you can use Samsung SmartThings to trigger these on or off or change scenes or what have you. So, you know, ultimately the best integration with the rest of the smart home community is here with Philips. So in the end, what it comes down to for me is kind of what I was just talking about. These are great. I love the many hubs that I can connect to. These are great because they're probably going to be the cheapest in the end, as long as you keep that purchase in mind. You could tell I'm a little annoyed by that with IKEA, but you know, in the end, they're still going to be the cheapest. We know IKEA is very good at being an inexpensive producer, and they do work. There's nothing wrong with those bulbs at all, and they have a good suite of them, and now they have a smart home plug. So this is still a good system as well. But what I come back to is I can usually buy the Philips Hue bulbs, the standard bulbs, on sale. They're not going to cost me a lot more than any of these other bulbs. And in the end, they're so nice to turn on and off. They're great dimming. Their colors are fantastic. And the suite of products continues to build out and build out and build out. So I can buy a light fixture in my bedroom or for my bedroom, in my kitchen, in my living room. I can buy all different kinds of, you know, strip lighting. I can buy outdoor products with these guys, and if I want, I can even have a mirror in my bathroom with Philips Hue integration or Philips Hue bulbs within it. So the capability of buying all these different light fixtures and the ability to have up to 50 devices on that Philips Hue bridge. You can have multiple bridges. I wouldn't put them next to each other, but you can have multiple bridges. It just gives you the opportunity to really build out your smart home. And again, I can usually get the bulbs cheaper than their standard selling price. So ultimately, guys, what it comes down to for me, Philips Hue. So that was a long answer to a relatively short question, but this is why I couldn't just answer that in the comments. And I felt like it was the right time to come and start this series on answering your guys' questions. So you know what? Let's open it up. What are your next questions? Do you have more questions about these bulbs that I need to answer next week? Would you like me to go through something else about home automation or the smart home in general and give you some more details about any of this? Leave those comments down below. Leave the questions down below. And of course, join our channel so you can see your questions answered as I can get to them. So thanks for watching, everyone, and we'll see you next time.